nut house. It was the longest I'd ever been confined. So a few people had been killed. It wasn't my fault.
Please, no, I got a family.
Shut
please.
Up and
no.
Bleed, you motherfucker. Well, maybe it was my fault, but I had my own problems to worry about. The old man's curse was beginning to piss me off. But then one day, he showed up. Calypso, he called himself. It was a stupid name. I wanted to kill him there and then, but he made me an offer. He said he ran some kind of crazy contest. If I won his game, he promised to show me how to bring an end to the curse. No more headaches. As much as I had those old urges of mine, I kept them to myself for the moment. I figured I'd play along with his little game. After all, I could always kill him later. dying heartbeat of a little girl. It was the first time in forever I hadn't felt the burning and the dreams. Boys and girls, those were some wonderful dreams. All my greatest achievements flashed before my eyes. The scale of what I'd done, the sheer volume of people I'd killed, it was breathtaking. But like all good things, it had to end sometime. When they captured me, the only thing I could think was, what a waste. All those people I hadn't killed yet. Come the night of my execution, there must have been over 1,000 people gathered outside to watch me fry. I was upset about that. There should have been more. I remember there was this preacher in the observation room. I figured he was just some Bible thumper wanting to save my soul. But as it turned out, the old man had something else in mind. As I fried, he started screaming out like the freak he was. He asked God to curse me, to burden me forever with the flames of hell. It took me less than a minute to kill 3 police officers and get my mask back on. I never used to believe in curses, but it's been 3 months since that night, and the pain gets worse every day. So let me tell you something, boys and girls. I sure as hell believe in curses now.
Downtown City Code 4432. Step out of your vehicle and surrender peacefully. Time's up.
It held the blood of the man who'd cursed me on the night of my execution. He told me if I drank it, my curse would be over. But he also said if I ever returned to my killing ways, the antidote would wear off, and the curse would come back to haunt me. I had to decide. It took me all of 10 seconds. Let's face it, boys and girls. A man has to have his priorities. I killed Calypso about as well as I ever killed anyone. Now that I'm free, I'm going to be the greatest of all time.